Good evening, everyone. So our project is Aakash Developers Portal, an enhancement to Aakash Tech Support Portal. My team, Anmol Singh from Bits Pilani, Deepak Agarwal from BMCET Surat, Ashok from Manipal Institute of Technology, Manipal, and myself, Vishesh, I'm from SRM University, Chennai. Our mentors are Parag sir, Tushar sir, and Nilesh sir, under whose guidance we started this project two months back, actually saying, and we've reached our goal. So our project is about making communication between the tablet users and between the technical and the developers team. So here, the users who use the Aakash tablet, actually, they can come across with the developers as well as the technical people so that they can be helped on whatever problems they face. So our project is divided into two parts, that is the developers portal as well as the tech support portal. So first, we'd like to have a look at what technologies we used. It has been developed, both the portal, that is the tech support as well as the developers portal, both have been developed on Joomla 2.5, that is a content management system. Then PHP 5.3 is the version that we used. CSS, that is the cascade styling sheet that has been used for all styling of our front-end web pages. Then JavaScript, HTML5 is the basic thing that we have used for our website purpose. Ajax and MySQL for our database. So first we'll have a look at the tech support portal. Now the tech support portal, it has been designed for the users who have been facing some problems with the Aakash tablet related to any issues, including the applications that have been developed. They can come up here and they can have their problems seen. So here the people, the users, they can interact with the people, that is the technical people. And it has been developed mainly because of ease of access, quick solution, and speedy response. This has been developed only considering the fact that people who are using the tablet, they should have their queries solved within a limited period of time so that the interaction is better between them. So the modules, that is the first one, is the discussion forum. The discussion forum is an open to all thing where any person who owns a tab and he has any queries related to anything, he can come up here, post up whatever the problem he has, and they will be answered not by the technical people, but they'll be answered by the other people who have been using that tab. It's kind of, I put up a problem and another user who has faced the similar problem, he can solve it there. The next one is FAQs. FAQs are static things that have been put up that are the normal questions that may come up according as per your use. So the most frequent questions that they come up, they have been put up. Query oblique ticketing system. This is the main feature or the main highlight of the tech support portal. I'll be getting it back. Then feedback forms, feedback for us, and chat options. Chat options is basically online chat that can facilitate talking between you and the one of the technical members who are sitting at the backend servers. So first is the ticketing system. A ticket we are calling to a query that is being submitted. A person who holds a tab, he has a tab ID, Mac ID, a registered Mac ID actually, a registered email address and his name. So he can log in using his Mac tablet ID or an email address. There, he can pull up his query, whatever problem he is facing. So now this query, it will have a complete description of what his problem is, how long he's been facing, and something. So this will be at the back end. It will be issued to one person. Now the admin panel has one administrator and subsequent representatives. Representatives are assigned to every category. For example, if I belong to one application, I'll be a technical person for that. And whatever queries are coming to my department, they'll be from the admin panel, they will be assigned to me directly. So I can handle those tickets, I can give response to them, and if the user is satisfied with my answers, he can close the ticket. That means an issue has been, a particular issue, whatever he issued, is solved. Now tickets have to be replied by the member and then closed. As I said, it will be assigned to one particular person, and the best feature is whatever email address you use for registering for your tab, your whole communication goes through that. There an API key is generated that is sent to your email ID. So all the communication for one particular ticket, it happens through your email address. You can view there. A link is given where you can click on that, have a look. And in case you are not satisfied with the answer, you can continue your thread again. So you can answer it back again and again, as many times as possible, until and unless your query is not solved or you are not satisfied. The list of ticket details can be exported anytime. This is the main backend feature for the administrator. We've tried to make the work of the backend administrator is here. That is, they need to have a log of how many tickets are coming, what department, and what ways. So we've created some dynamic pages where they can select what things they want, and they can be directly exported into an Excel sheet as a report format. So that was all about the ticketing system. So that concludes actually the tech support. We'll have a demo of it first.
So in the first portal, the tech support portal, this is the front page. Yeah. So so all the Aakash tablet users who have like bought Aakash tablets from IIT Bombay are provided with an 8-digit number which specifies the details. So I've given a list of features which the Aakash user who has a problem with the tablet has to like follow. So the first step, like if any Aakash user has a problem with the tablet, is that he has to register on this website. Then he can go to the FAQs and see the most common problems which are faced by the users. After that, even after going to the FAQs, his problem is not solved, he can then go to the discussions and discuss his problem. And in the end, we have the ticketing system which Vishesh just discussed. So the tickets is a new feature which has like come up lately, and it is a very good feature. I'll just show you. So first of all, the user has to register. I'll give a demo. Say his name is like Nilesh. His email is nil@gmail.com. His username is also Nilesh. Password is Nilesh. Actually, we have a lot of these are fields are checked by the software and any repetition is not allowed. And now we have the tablet ID, which is a simple 8-digit ID, which is unique for every Aakash tablet. For example, I'll just give a random number here, 7777. Register. After registering, your data is transferred to the IIT Bombay database, and we can check the email addresses and the tablet IDs. Then the person can simply log into the website. During the first login, he can change his like details and add his pictures and all. I'll skip them for now. So the first step which any user has to follow, like if he has a problem, is go to the FAQs. The FAQs are a list of simple problems which are like commonly faced by all the users, and I put them into categories: hardware and software problems and general problems. In hardware and software problems, these are simple drop-down problems and questions, like in the common hardware software like Android issues. Let's go to how to install Aakash application on the tablet. If you click on this, the answer it comes in a drop-down. Now feature has been added that you can like upvote or downvote the answer. If you're already logged in, you can like obviously upvote the answer. And this upvoting and downvoting, it helps for the administrator to as a simple feedback if the answer is right or wrong. Now there's a new feature in the FAQs that you can ask a new question. If you are already registered on the website, so you can just go and you can like submit a question, like for example, a new question. This new question will go to the back end of the administrator, and administrator on his like on his next login, he can see the question, and if the question is valid enough, he can add it as a future FAQ. The next, if the user who has a problem with this tablet is not satisfied with the FAQ, he has to go to the discussion tab. The second module is the discussion module. As you can see, this is a very general discussion forum which has all the features of a simple forum. When the user goes to the discussion forum, he can see the already discussed topics, for example, proximity is not working, is already being discussed. And if his topic is not already there, he can go to new topic he can go to new topic tab. He can go to the new topic tab, and he can add his new discussion topic. For example, tablet charger not working. You can submit this new topic, and any user who logs onto the website in the future, he'll see this topic in the discussion and he can either like reply to the topic and or join the discussion. Like for example, now the tablet charger not working issue is a new discussion forum. Anyone who can just visit the forum and he can like reply to the topic. Like check the pin, anything. He can reply anything here, and this forum is a very general forum, and it will not be administrator. Like the administrators here in the logistic team or the developer team, they will not be like moderating this forum because it will have a lot of data. So this forum will be like self moderated. All the people will simply come here, discuss their problems, and check their problems. And even after going to the discussion, if the problem is not solved, then the user has to submit his issue. Now here we have come to the ticketing system. He has to submit his tablet ID. This one was. When you have to submit your issue, you have to verify your 8-digit tablet ID. For this user, the tablet ID was 7777. So after submitting, his all details are shown and he has to submit a ticket. Now in the ticketing system, the details of the user are already like pre-filled in the form. He has to submit some new details. Now here is the best feature of the ticketing system. The help topics are already selected, like harder problems and softer problems. And we have like some subcategories here. We can obviously provide the subject of the ticket, like charger not working, and write a small message. Submit. This ticket has been submitted. Now, the basic idea of the ticketing system is that the entire tech support team has been divided into like two departments, either like the software department and the hardware department. And any issue or the ticket which has been submitted with a particular problem, it will be like directly directed to like that department only. So like once the ticket has been created under the hardware support department, an email will be directed to towards the corresponding the tech support member. So in future, the user of the Aakash tablet, he has to like re-log into the website and go to the view issues tab where he can see his ticket. The ticket has to be answered by the administrator in the back end. The next feature is a simple feedback form which has to be filled and it will go to the administrator for his response. I have also provided a simple chat a chat option. If the administrator is online, he can chat with the administrator and he can like discuss his problems. Now, this was all about the tech support portal, about the developers portal.
The second section is the developers portal. This is not open to all of the users who use the tablet. It is only meant for the technical people, the support team, logistics, as well as the developers. Here, the people who want to contribute, actually saying, who want to contribute to their codes and all those applications, they can have discussions and their procedures.
The second website is the developers portal. The developers portal is a simple website which brings all the developers into a common workplace. So this is the front page of the developers portal. It has like many modules. The first one is the forum module, which is same as the previous website. But here the discussions will be like more about and the codes and the problems in the code and simple bug solving in the codes. I need not go into the details because it is the same as the previous website. The next module is the developers blog.
The developers blog is an outlet to what is happening in IIT Bombay. If IIT Bombay is undergoing a new project, so then the administrator, he'll put up a new blog topic. This blog topic, it can be viewed by any user who logs into the website. He can just like go to the blog topic and check it out. After reading the blog topic, he can read the blog topic. He can like print it or email it or even like post his comments if he wants.
The next module is a training module. The training module is divided into two parts, like video lectures and study material. In video lectures, I have provided like all those videos which will help the developers in creating new applications. These have been divided into two categories, lectures and tutorials. I'll go to lectures. We already have two demo videos here. One is Professor D. Fatak speech. This is a demo. After watching the video, people can rate it or add comments to it. In the training section, the second subtopic is study material. In study material, we'll be providing simple downloadable study materials which can be hovered to view the details, and on a single click they can be downloaded. And if the users want to rate the topics, the downloadable material, they can also do that. It's a single click download, and any slides or any workshop assignments which are given, they can be just uploaded here for the user to download. The second last module is the projects. It has two subcategories: new ideas and the existing projects. The existing projects is the going on projects in IIT Bombay, like proximity, etc. They can be just hovered upon to view the details. And this one is much more interesting. The new ideas. This one, in the subtopic, if a developer, he has a new idea about creating an application, so he can just post his idea here. So in this module, the users, they can like provide more ideas which can be upvoted and commented. And the last section is a downloads, where simple like downloadable applications can be provided for the user to download. Thank you. So questions?
You didn't mention any learnings of the 2-month stay here. So what did you learn?
So we have learned a lot about PHP, MySQL, and so like simple DBMS, so Joomla, and SQL, so queries and all.
My questions are over.